why did you call your record Music for Men?
Because we do not like women.
I'm Stuart Diamond.
I think it was really funny. We wanted it to be ironic. The idea that either I wanted the cover to be Nathan in a top hat.
Who's next? I'll pick it. I'll pick the person. Here, can I pick the person? This will be a fun game. Are you ready?
Oh, Bronski B.
Yes.
I love the gays. I'm always like, sometimes I look at like people I know in their lives and I'm like, I am so glad I'm gay. I can't get pregnant on accident.
Yes.
I'm game for anything. I'm like, what? You want to make me look like a zebra? Perfect. You know, it's like, I'm really into looking crazy. The crazier the better, actually. It's daytime. Have you seen my face?
Yeah.
Yeah. Andrew. I wish Nathan would get a boyfriend.
Yeah.
I listened to so much 80s Tina Turner in this record, and I started to realize that was my favorite era. Because I think most music nerds will be like, man, it's all about the 60s. And I'm like, no way, it's the 80s. It's all about legs. And this is probably going to make a lot of people go, oh, mark it off. But is that they're always like, oh, is Nathan, you know, like, Nathan, how do you feel being in a band with two lesbians?
Normal.
He's like,
fine.
Like being in a band? You know, it's like, come on, shh, I'll answer.
Yeah.
No, but.
Yeah.
I think empowerment is really important, just trying to reach out to kids who maybe are from a small town or feel alienated or feel weird.
Maybe being in a major, and one of the things that you, like, being like 28 and being a teenager in the 90s, Nirvana got really big. And we were just talking earlier about the video, The Year Punk Broke, and how vital that was to our music, our relationship to music, because it really introduced us to so many things in the underground. You know, because of Sonic Youth, you heard about the Raincoats. You know, because of Nirvana, you heard about Sonic Youth. Because of Sonic Youth, you heard about the Raincoats. And it was more marketable, and, you know, that's capitalism for you, whatever, like your music industry. But that's the way it works. And because of Nirvana, we got to hear the Splits. You know, and the idea of being able to do that I feel really lucky that we get to be at this press conference with all these people talking about feminism and, like, talking about, like, the bands that influenced us to make us just be as crazy as we are. America was built on, like, this idea of you go in, destroy everything,
village,
and rebuild
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
And then people actually care about enough about things here that they will preserve them.
Yeah.
And it's just not a very American ethic, I think. And that's what's really nice about Europe. I think that says a lot about how they appreciate art.
Yeah.
And preserving that and that, actually taking that into consideration with culture and how they go hand in hand.
Like
I think that says a lot about the difference between Europe and America.
And you know, in Paris, like, we were walking around and there's all these, you know, beautiful golden statues. And if those weren't America, they'd be like spray painted. You know, so.
Which is its own kind of cool thing.
Yeah, yeah. That is cool, yes.
It's true. Thanks.
Hi. How are you?
Hello.
Incredible, like the amount of artistic talent and just crazy perfection that goes into those videos. It's unbelievable.
It's kind of like a video pioneer. Like,
yeah. He was the first black artist on MTV. You know, he's a groundbreaking artist, and I think it's really shocking and sad that he's dead.
I thought he was my husband as a child, literally.
And Cyndi Lauper was
my sister. I thought Cyndi Lauper was my sister and that I was married to Michael Jackson. That was what I thought. And those were the facts.
Crazy child.
I was just like, well, that's true. So accept it and move on.
Good thing you grew out of schizophrenia.
Yeah. I still think that. But talk about the lyrics out loud, like to recite them, it sounds so stupid. Take your favorite song, no matter how much you like it, write it down in a poem and just read it out loud. It sounds stupid as hell, always. So like that's
my worst.
La la la. Yeah.
La la la. La 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 la.
Exactly. Oh wow. You know, so it was that simple.
Coffee from Italy.
Hi.
After being in the, I just want to make an announcement to the public that after being in the UK with their shitty coffee, this is the best thing that's ever happened to me. Thank you, Italian.
Slow down.
Who wants to go next?
You wins a sort of mainstream success just now.
what is the mass market for you? An opportunity or a structure?
McDonald's. I guess it's an opportunity, but I think it's still kind of not real for us, like mainstream. It's.
I always keep in mind the career that I'm going to do when this is over in 6 months. You know, I'm always, always, like, oh, since 10 years ago, since now, I'm like, save your money.
Hairdresser.
Keep a nest egg. Yes, true. Keep the nest egg because you're going to have to go to hairdressing school. So, I mean, I always do because it can't last forever. And, you know, that's the thing. I think that people get destroyed. It's like, they're like, oh my God, my career's over. You're like, yep, but there's time for a new one. You're 28 years old. You're 35. Who gives a shit? The best moment in my life was playing that song Born in 6'6 by Nina Hagen for this 10-year-old, and she had this crazy shrill voice, and you know, people in the class were getting so annoyed with her because it was so loud and high. She was just like, ah! And she loved aliens. She was obsessed with aliens. And I let her hear Nina Hagen, and this is what happened to her. She was just like, because she'd never heard anything like that. You know, all she'd heard is Mariah Carey, which is really cool, but no one ever said, you can sound fucking crazy, and it's awesome. So that's like the best thing ever. Like I teach them how to sound stupid and be okay with it, basically. So, and actually I had a voice like, you know, I had a voice right. Like Mama Cass or Dolly Parton or something like that. And I always really resisted it. So I had to embrace it. Yeah. Thanks for the question.
Gracias.
Quiet journalists. Single file. Everyone can finger up their mouth, single file.
We have classmates. I am shaking. That coffee fucked me up so bad.
Hey, I don't know how to say it. Okay. Ciao.